Hello, darlings. You've all heard of Marilyn Monroe. Some of you know Bridget Bardot. Well, now it's time for the Cognac Show. I said Cognac, ooh, ooh. I said Cognac, ooh, ooh, ooh. I'm your bubbly blonde, fabulously dressed.
Thank you. LLS org, Leukemia Lymphoma Society organization, Night on the Town. And I'm here with this young lady who is going to introduce herself and tell us what this event is really all about.
My name is Cristina Curatolo. I'm the Deputy Executive Director of the Leukemia Lymphoma Society. And Night on the Town is an annual night to celebrate the fight against cancer and to raise funds to invest in much-needed life-saving research.
I understand that this event, you're celebrating what year exactly?
This event has been happening for almost 10 years now.
10 years, that's marvelous.
And we are on track to raise more than $140,000, which would set a new fundraising record.
You're also honoring somebody very important tonight. Tell my audience who that is.
Yes, tonight we are honoring Kevin Lilazarian of Lilazarian Properties. He's a local Long Islander who has been very generous in supporting LLS and many other nonprofits.
What the Leukemia Lymphoma Society, what is your mission? What would you like to accomplish? What's your goal for this year?
You know, we'd like to be put out of business because we would like a cure. Our mission is to cure the blood cancers, leukemia, lymphoma, Hodgkin's disease, and myeloma, and to improve the quality of life for patients and their families.
You know, I've read so much about this illness, especially leukemia, and people that go into their 60s seem to be very susceptible in getting leukemia. Why do you think that is?
You know, there's nobody knows the
answer. Well, really not.
But what we do know is that there is a cure out there, and our mission is to find it. You know, when we were founded back in 1949, the survival rate for kids with leukemia was 3%, totally unacceptable. Today, 92%.
Oh my God, that's marvelous.
We've come a really long way, and we are not going to stop until all cancers have a survival rate of 100%.
You're doing a terrific job. This event is spectacular.
Thank you.
It's the first time I've ever come, and I'd like to come again next year.
I'd love to have you. Thank you.
Tell my audience, come a little closer, darling. Tell my audience where we could go to find out more information. What is the website?
www.lls.org.
Fabulous. Well, thank you so much.
Pleasure.
Don't go away yet. We'll be back in a moment, darlings. More interviews coming up. Keep watching. Pink champagne kisses.
You know, I was doing typical stuff. I was running around playing basketball.
He was a sports star. He played soccer. He played baseball. He played basketball.
For fun.
Football practice, cheerleading.
You know, I was a pretty good bicyclist.
An avid bowler. I go to
trained
major
for the New York City triathlon.
Park. We go to the movies.
That.
We draw. We paint.
These were busy schedules. Yeah.
I was in the middle of my associate's degree.
Mother of two young boys.
A student. You know, attending class. Yeah,
my friends. Causing problems with my brothers. You know.
It's a joy.
You know. Typical stuff.
Just normal. Life was pretty good.
We would take our children for physical checkups.
And they took a blood test, which was procedure.
About 1 o'clock that afternoon, I got the phone call from her saying that
Kayla has leukemia.
Acute leukemia. Chronic leukemia.
Hodgkin's disease.
AML.
Chronic myeloid leukemia.
Myeloma.
I just thought about, I'm gonna lose my son.
All I could think of is, who's gonna take care of my kids?
I knew I wasn't going to see my grandchildren anymore. They
told me that you have cancer, and I'm like,
say why your son?
Why me? Why?
It was all the unknown, and
it's
it was the fear of the unknown.
That it's an anxiety.
I mean, I was in Vietnam for 12 months. I was scared then.
Where do we go from here? What do we do?
God be with me. Don't let me die.
This news made that a cakewalk.
I was in denial.
I was in denial. Pure shock.
I said, I need to go home. I have class tomorrow.
It was the most horrific feeling in the world.
It's intense. It's very intense. They go through a lot of procedures. They go through a lot of emotional difficulty, you know, physical.
They basically threw me into surgery. I had a port catheter put into my chest for the chemo.
Is an experience no parent should ever have to
every cold
experience.
virus infection. I thought that was known to man.
All your head gonna come out.
Very fatigued and very nauseated.
Wouldn't want to eat, he wouldn't want to drink.
The simplest thing is getting up to brush your teeth. It's a hard job for someone that has cancer.
I don't know how people do this. I couldn't have gotten through this alone.
I called the Leukemia and Lymphoma Society up that night.
What do we do next? How do we fight this? What are the next steps?
The Leukemia and Lymphoma Society will call me up and ask me if I need support.
They sent me information in the mail immediately. They sent me emails.
And that information is...
The more educated you get about the particular disease that you have...
Vital.
The more you know how to make informed decisions...
They helped me with moral support.
You realize that it just wasn't him fighting this disease, it was everyone, his family,
cancer
his
needs
friends,
a community.
The community.
The society, through First Connection, connected me with another woman who was also diagnosed at the age of 40, who also had two young children.
Leukemia and Lymphoma Society is there to support me.
They're there for you 24/7. They're wonderful.
If you stay strong, I stay strong with you.
Standing here today, I know I'm not alone.
Be there to give them hope.
Without research, we can't do it.
LLS funds research.
And without money, we can't research.
LLS helps find cures.
Cures are possible.
Cure is possible. With your help, I can be cured. Without you, my soul may not be here.
Research saves lives.
The society saves lives.
It absolutely saves lives. It's making people aware of the disease.
With your help, we can beat blood cancers.
Hope for the positive and never give up. Never.
Thank you for being involved.
Thank you for helping my son.
Thank you for helping my sister.
Thank you for helping me.
Thank you for helping my family.
Thank you very much for helping my family.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Every 3 minutes, someone in the U.S. is diagnosed with a blood cancer. Despite progress, more than a third of blood cancer patients still do not survive 5 years after their diagnosis. But thanks to the research funded by the Leukemia and Lymphoma Society, in the field and on the horizon, we now have a real opportunity to change that outcome. With continued support, thousands of patients who don't respond well to current treatments will have hope with better tolerated treatment options. With your help, we can ensure that patients get better access to life-saving treatments, therapies, and quality of life.
I live.
I live.
I live.
I live.
I live.
She lives.
Because of the research done by the Leukemia and Lymphoma Society in the battle against blood cancer.
This could be your son, daughter, husband, wife, mother, or father. If you had a chance to support the research that is saving lives, what would you do?
Team in training. Train to save lives. Marathons, half marathons, triathlons, cycling. Get it done. Team in training. Join. Get in shape. Raise money. Save lives.
Is Rhett Crowley. I am 8 years old and leukemia is cancer in my blood. Cancer cells are the bad guys. For 3.5 years, I took chemo to get the bad guys out. Thanks to the Leukemia and Lymphoma Society, I'm gone with the cancer. Leukemia and Lymphoma Society is a health organization that funds research, finds cures, and gives treatments to blood cancer patients. Every 3 minutes, someone is diagnosed with blood cancer, including kids like me. We want to help them too. Every year, LLS hosts the Pacific Union Leukemia Cup Regatta. It's a big sailing event that raises money to cure blood cancers. Skippers of big boats and small boats register and recruit friends to raise money. Crew members ask their families and friends to sponsor their boat. This year, I'm sailing in the Pacific Union Leukemia Cup Regatta. So someday, everyone can be gone with the cancer. It's easy. Just go to sflcup.org.
Will you please join my crew? Why? Because my name is Rhett and I give a damn.
Welcome back, darlings. I'm Cognac Wellerlane, and we are here at the Leukemia Lymphoma Society Night on the Town Charity Gala. I'm here with this very prominent businessman, and he's going to introduce himself to the camera.
Hi, my name is Michael Brightman. I am a certified business coach with Action Coach of Metro New York and the Berkshires, and I'm here to support.
Yes, and tell my audience, why are you such a big supporter of this organization?
Well, my father was friendly with Patsy Lubrano, who was one of the founders of the Busla restaurant group, and I'm here to support his memory. He was a great guy.
How many years have you been coming to this event?
Actually, actually my first time here.
Really?
Yeah. But what I've owned the Lebrano family for 30 years. This is 1980. More than 30 years.
What do you think of this event? Pretty exciting, isn't it?
Yeah. Great band.
Fantastic.
Yeah, it's great. Great restaurants, great band. It's wonderful.
It sure is. Tell my audience, where can we go to find out more information about this charity? To find out more information, what is the website?
LLS.org.
Beautiful. In a moment, darlings, more interviews coming up. Keep watching. Pink Champagne Kisses.
Hello, darlings. You've all heard of Marilyn Monroe. Some of you know Bridget Fonda.
Been a Crybaby Productions, darlings.